chips and the English salad, and the children have drank the English water. We've eaten very well this evening. We live in the suburbs of London, and our last name is Smith. Oh, the potatoes were very good, fine and fat, and the salad bowl was not rancid. The salad bowl from the grocer at the corner is much better than the salad bowl than the grocer at the bottom of the street. But I will not tell them that. Mary did the potatoes very well. Sometimes she doesn't do them well. I do not like them well done. The fish was fresh. It made my mouth water. I had 2 helpings, no 3. That made me go to the water closet. You had 3 helpings. However, the 3rd time you took less than the 1st time. Well, as many, I took a great deal more. I ate better than you this evening. Why is that? It is usually you that eats more. It's not appetite you lack. Oh, my goodness. Oh, but still, the soup is a little salty. It was saltier than you. And too many leeks and not enough onions. Oh, next time I will tell Mary to add those little Ionesco stars. Oh, our little boy wanted to drink some beer. Did you see how he was staring at that bottle? He's gonna love getting tiddly. He's like you at the table. Drink English beer. She's our daughter who will eat porridge and drink milk. She's only 2 and her name is Peggy. The quince and meat pie was marvelous. It would have been nice to have a little glass of Australian Burgundy with this sweet. But I do not want to do a bad example for the children. We must set a good example. We don't want them to have any gluttony. They must learn to be sober and different. Miss Parker is a Romanian grocer by the name of Ionesco, who just came from Constantinople. He's a great specialist in yogurt. He got a degree from yogurt school at Constantinople. Tomorrow I shall buy a huge pot of native Romanian yogurt from him. One doesn't find no such things in the suburbs of London. Yogurt is excellent for the stomach, the kidneys, the appendicitis, the hypothesis. It was Dr. Mackenzie King who told me that. He's the one who first took care of the children of the neighbors, the Johns. He's a good doctor. One can trust him. He never prescribes medicine for anyone that he hasn't first tried for himself. Before operating on Parker, he had his own liver operated on. Although he was not even the least bit ill.
And how does it happen the doctor pulled through and Parker died?
Because the operation was successful in the doctor's case, but it was not in Parker's.
Then Mackenzie is not a good doctor. The operation should have succeeded with both of them, or both should have died.
Why?
Conscientious doctor must die with his patient if they can't get them all together. The captain of a ship goes down with the ship into the briny deep. He does not survive alone.
We cannot compare a patient with a ship.
Why not? A ship has its diseases too. And your doctor's as hale as a ship. That's why you should have perished at the same time as the patient, like the captain in his ship.
Oh, I hadn't thought of that. Perhaps it is true. And then what conclusion do you draw from this?
All doctors are quacks. All patients, too.
But
only the Royal Navy is honest in England.
Oh, but not sailors.
Naturally. And here's the thing I don't understand. In the newspaper, they always give the age of the deceased person, but never the age of the newly born. That doesn't make sense.
I've never thought of that.
Well, it says here that Bobby Watson died. To be astonished. You know very well he's been dead these past 2 years, on Mitchell's funeral a year and a half ago.
Oh, yes, of course. I do remember. remember. I remembered it right away, but I didn't understand why you yourself were so surprised to see it in the paper.
Wasn't in the paper. It's been 3 years since that death was announced. I got it through an association of ideas.
Oh, what a pity. He was so well preserved.
He was the handsomest corpse in Great Britain. He didn't look his age. He'd been dead for 4 years, and he was still warm, a veritable living corpse. And how cheerful he was.
Poor Bobby.
Now, what poor Bobby do you mean?
It is his wife, I mean. She is called Bobby, too. Bobby Watson. Since they both had the same name, you could never tell one from the other when you saw them together. It was only after his death that you could really tell which was which. And there are still people today who confuse her with the deceased. I offer their condolences to him. Do you know her?
I only met her once, by chance, at Bobby's funeral.
Oh, I've never seen her. Is she pretty?
Well, she has regular features, but one cannot say that she's pretty. She's too big and stout. Her features are not regular, but one can say that she's pretty. She's a little thin and small, and she's a voice teacher.
Oh, and when do they plan to be married, those two?
Next spring at the latest.
Oh, we shall have to go to their wedding, I suppose.
We'll have to give them a wedding present. Wonder what?
Oh, why don't we give them one of those 7 silver slippers that we cut for our wedding and we have never had any use for? Dear, look. Well, how sad for her to be a widow so young.
Fortunately, they had no children.
Oh, that's all they needed, children. Poor woman, how could she have managed?
She's still young. She may very well remarry. She looked very well in mourning.
But who would take care of the children? You know very well they have a boy and a girl. What are their names?
Well, Bobby and Bobby like their parents. Bobby Watson's uncle, old Bobby Watson, is a rich man and very fond of the boy. He might very well pay for Bobby's education.
Well, that would be proper. And Bobby Watson's aunt, old Bobby Watson, might very well, in turn, pay for the education of Bobby Watson, Bobby Watson's daughter. That way, Bobby Watson's mother, could remarry. Has she anyone in mind?
Yes, a cousin of Bobby Watson.
Who? Bobby Watson?
Why, which Bobby Watson do you mean?
Well, Bobby Watson, the son of old Bobby Watson, the late Bobby Watson's older uncle.
No, it's not that one, it's someone else. It's Bobby Watson, the son of old Bobby Watson, the late Bobby Watson's aunt.
Oh, are you referring to Bobby Watson, the commercial traveler?
All the Bobby Watsons are commercial travelers.
Oh, what a difficult trade. However, they do it well.
Yes, when there's no competition.
And when is there competition?
On Tuesdays and Thursdays and Tuesdays and...
Oh, 3 days a week. And what does Bobby Watson do on those days?
He rests, he sleeps.
So why doesn't he work those 3 days when there's no competition?
I don't know everything. I can't answer all your idiotic questions.
Oh.
Well, but I'm not.
You men, you're all alike. You smoke your cigarettes, you rouge your lips, you powder your face, you drink all day like a fish.
What would you say if you saw men acting like women, smoking all day, rouging, powdering, and drinking whiskey?
Oh, that's nothing to me. But if you're only saying that to annoy me, and you're all that kind of joking, you know that very well.
Oh, my little ducky daddles, what a little spitfire you are. You know I was only joking. What a ridiculous pair of lovers we are.